Hello everyone, we are back. We were in Daton where we have a story, and that story will be up soon. But while we were on our way from Daton to Nandigram, two big stories have broken in West Bengal, and it's making a lot of noise here. I don't know if it's making as much noise in Delhi media, but we'll give you a bit of an update of what's happening here. Two purported audios have been leaked by both the parties, BJP and TMC. We'll tell you a bit about these audios and why they're making so much news here. The first audio is purportedly of Mamata Banerjee in conversation with Pralay Pal, who is currently in the BJP, but he used to be in the TMC. He quit TMC around 2011 and has been there way before Suvendu Adhikari. Now, in this purported call, I'm saying purported again because we're not sure right now of what and who recorded it, who leaked it. But anyway, in this call, what you can hear is Mamata Banerjee supposedly saying that, calling Pralay Pal on to help her with this election, saying that you're a very young, dynamic leader. Why don't you help us? And he's complaining about the party, that how he was mistreated and how now his allegiances lie with the BJP, so he can't help her. So that's the gist of the audio that's been leaked. Snigdhendu, just tell us, why is this so explosive?
This is explosive because this kind of shows that Mamata Banerjee is in a kind of desperation to win over people from the BJP, especially those with a background in the TMC. So the BJP is trying to portray this incident as something that reveals how Mamata Banerjee is in trouble in Nandigram.
Okay. And what does the TMC have to say about this?
The TMC leaders, they haven't made many official comments, but one of their spokespersons, Kunal Ghosh, he said that he couldn't verify the voice if it belonged to the chief minister. But even if it belonged to her, Kunal Ghosh says that there is no wrong in a party's leader in trying to reach out to disgruntled leaders and asking them to return. Kunal Ghosh said that chief minister is openly saying from all the public rallies, asking leaders who have switched over or who have become inactive to be active and return to TMC. So there is no problem. He also personally calls up a few of them.
So now the second audio has been leaked now from the TMC camp, it appears, and it's a BJP, purportedly again, two big BJP leaders, Mukul Roy and Shishir Bajoria. They are in conversation, and you can again hear them basically talk about how they should lobby with the election commission to allow them to bring polling agents from anywhere in the state. Now, traditionally, polling agents of a booth have to be from that booth. What's the rule on that, Meghnath?
So, polling agents functionally have to operate as like agents of the political party. So, they are at the polling station. They will check the VVPATs, EVMs. They will check if it's sealed properly, etc. They also have this job of identifying impersonators. So, traditionally, the handbook says that they have to be from a local area. The exact words being that a local person might be knowing many of the electors personally and might be of assistance in preventing impersonation at election. Therefore, the polling agent shall be ordinarily a resident and electors of the concerned polling areas of the neighborhood polling station. So it says ordinarily, which means that it is not really mandatory that the person has to be from here, but because their function demands that they know the local area, they know the electors, they make sure there are no impersonators. Therefore, this is in the handbook. So that is what the whole thing is.
And why this tape is explosive is because they are talking about lobbying with the election commission, and the election commission did allow the BJP to get polling agents from any place in the state. Snigdhendu, explosive, not explosive?
This kind of vindicates TMC's, I mean, this TMC shows it as it vindicating their past allegation that the EC is favoring the BJP. Now, just a few hours before this purported audio clip emerged, the TMC held a press conference in which Senior Minister Subrata Mukherjee and Senior Rajya Sabha MP Derek O'Brien, they were addressing the PC. And there they said, they raised the same issue and saying that how the EC can change this rule on the basis of deputation from one single party without calling an all-party meeting, without discussing any other party. So it shows how the BJP are just dictating terms to the ECI. This is what the press conference said. And before that, the TMC also submitted a deputation with the ECI protesting this decision. So immediately after TMC raised the issue of this change, this purported audio clip, they will try to play it up to show that there is a nexus between the ECI and the BJP.
I think, like you said earlier, that for this, we need to get the view of the left and the Congress, because they are neutral.
Yes, we should wait to see what the left and the Congress has to say on this. Because the BJP argues that this change was necessary because of political terror, that in certain areas, local residents would not dare to be a polling agent for the BJP, and so they will need to ferry their agents from other areas. This is what BJP's argument will be. This is what they have also previously said, the party's leaders, that they want this change.
Now, one last question I want to just ask you, which Meghnad and I were thinking about, was how are so many leaked audios doing the rounds? Like, how is these audios leaking? Is everyone tapping everyone's phone?
See, this is happening. This is going on here for quite a long time. Mukul Roy has repeatedly alleged that he comes under phone surveillance. Other BJP leaders have also alleged the same. TMC leaders have also alleged that their phones are being tapped by central agencies. So a game over phone tapping is going on here. Tapping and counter tapping is going on here for quite a long time, at least last past 3-4 years.
So tapping and counter tapping by state and center, and lots of audio leaks and a lot of explosive news for us journalists to cover. But yeah, the Election Commission has to address these concerns in a press conference.
So Snigdhendu, in the phone call, if I understand correctly, Mukul Roy actually points out that they don't have enough polling agents to send to all the polling stations. Can you explain that point and why it's important?
No, he didn't really mean that. I mean, the way he said that we won't be able to send agents in many booths. So this rule needs to be changed. Now, what it means and how the TMC alleges that it favors BJP is because there are nearly 79,000 polling booths in the state. And as of even 2-3 months ago, the BJP didn't have a booth level committee in nearly 10,000 of these 79,000 booths. So if you don't have a booth level committee, it is very unlikely for you to find a polling agent or a booth agent. So this is how TMC is saying that this rule has been changed to nullify the organizational deficiencies that the BJP has. BJP counters this saying that no, we need this to tackle the terror.
So to again clarify one more thing, so the presiding officer and the polling agents have to work together, right? So I just want to again understand whether this, if this rule wasn't changed, would it make the BJP a weaker party as opposed to CPIM, Congress and the TMC? And does the rule change actually favor them now? Is that a thing?
Yeah, actually not in comparison to left and the Congress, but definitely without this change in the rule, BJP would have been in a disadvantageous situation compared to the TMC, because in many booths they wouldn't have had their polling agents to look after if there are proxy voters or some malpractices are going on. But now, despite their organizational deficiencies, they will have a way to look after those issues.
I just wanted to add that we were discussing this, and I think the Election Commission does meet different parties before, and they do ask them for whether they have, you know, any issues, they have concerns about biases, and listens, takes the feedbacks and sometimes accepts it. So here the BJP is essentially trying to get the Election Commission to listen to its demands. But the question is if the Election Commission would have heard it had it been some other party.
Yeah, that remains a question, and yeah, that also remains a question whether the EC sought opinion from the TMC left or the Congress on this issue. We don't yet have that knowledge, that information, if the EC indeed sought their suggestion or did it solely on based on BJP's deputation.
Great, thank you so much, guys. That was it on the leaked explosive audios. I hope that was informative for you. If you like our work, please don't forget to subscribe to newslaundry.com.